outside India. And you know, the COVID-19 is the current situation is a very pandemic one, and you know the economic condition all over the world also. The first case of COVID-19 in India was reported in 30th January 2020 as per the record is telling, and day by day the infection rate is increasing, similarly death rate also increasing. At this time the government is facing the number of challenges. Building up the medical care facilities even in the remote areas in the country to meet the rising number of COVID-19 cases. That you know, it is a virus in which way it affects to all over the world. Keeping the supply chain of essential commodities, ensuring that more than 450 million migrants rendered jobless by the lockdown, and trudging of country's highway to return to their village. This is a pathetic one that you have seen through the number of social media. People think about the economic impact of these things. Due to nationwide lockdown, the country is facing economically down, not only India, but also the other countries. Around 400 million workers employed in the informal economy are at risk of falling their poverty during this crisis. Stock exchange Sensex also going down. People think about the socio-economic challenge, then sector-wise impact people consider, then we can go for the agriculture, textile, automotive section, aviation, hotel and restaurants, poultry section, chemicals, IT sectors, e-commerce, pharmaceuticals, entertainment and sports, consumer durables. So these are the number of sectors this pandemic situation is affecting now. On this situation, the NC Autonomous College has decided to start the international webinar, taking the help of good resource person, so that we will discuss about something as an academician to spread this knowledge among the community, so that it will be beneficial during lockdown period. So today the topic we have taken, the post-COVID-19 and socio-economic challenges. We have the resource person from